Hello friends, this is Bhushan Nemlekar, as decided as usual on the Acer Connect. And today I have a privileged guest as usual on, you know, which I always have on the Acer Connect. And her name is Smita Shetty. There has been a lot written already on the Acer Connect about it. And she has been featured on the Acer Connect earlier also. So I would like to introduce Smita first. As a student, she is a Nemlekarite. Of course, a long time back, she is a Dasarite also. And now she has gone to a different scale in life. She has written a book called Boss Lady, which is absolutely different from what the normal writings are. You know, like that's what I've read the book also. And that's the reason I wanted my viewers to interact with Smita, rather, you know, to know what she has written. So Smita, it's nice to have you on my DC Celeb talk, and I would like you to introduce yourself, you know, in a better way as what you have done in life and what is Boss Lady. Then I'll come back with the next questionnaire.
So I think you introduced me well. I'm a Dasarite by heart, a Mumbaikar by heart, born and brought up here, always been in Dasar, did my schooling from Vidya Mandir, and then went on to do my food science course. You know, I've done my bachelor's and master's in food science and nutrition, and, you know, around the food technology. And I got recruited to campus, always been in sales and marketing. And then I went on to do my leadership course from, you know, I'm an ISB and IMB alumni. So that's my qualification, 15 years into this role of business, being a business head. And that's what fascinates me, you know, building stories around products, you know, selling them, marketing them. So that's my core passion, customer centricity. So traveling job, so I've explored a lot of places, and I think nothing teaches you more than travel. And I'm a, you know, if you be with me, I'm kind of an extrovert, so I love interacting with people. That's why I wrote a book to, you know, from my experiences and my life lessons of the short period, just to share my views and my learnings with the audience. So that's me.
Yeah, it's a nice thing because, you know, like it is Neha Sawant, I think one of your colleagues who spoke about you. And she was also equally intelligent as what you are. And she just said, you know, like Smita Shetty has written this nice book. Why don't we, you interview her on DC Celeb Talk? And this is how, what the Acer Connect is, Smita, you know, like we always try and, you know, figure out or try and go for the diamonds who are in the Acer and put them on my the Acer Connect, you know, DC Celeb Talk, so that, you know, a population of around 4 to 5 lakhs in the Acer should know that there are people like you who are doing something different in life.
Yeah.
So my next question to you, Smita, is, how did you think about writing this book? You know, where did this thought process come into you of writing Boss Lady?
So I was already into blogging and sharing, you know, my thoughts with audience on WordPress. And then one day, a publisher approached me and said that, you know, you should extend it to a book. And then I thought, what should I write? And over 10, 15 years of interaction around me, I've seen a lot of women around me who are conditioned to think that they can't do much bigger role, or whenever you position to them, you know, that you apply for a bigger role in corporate ladder or you do something big, they are always hesitating. So I have seen this, and I've always kept talking to them, motivating them, and told my example to them, you know, you think big, you will achieve it. So I thought, why not pen that down, those experiences, and anyone, and you know, who feels low at that point can pick it up. It's a short read. It's a 96-page read. And deliberately kept so, because I personally like to read those thin books, which I can go and reread again and again. So a lot of people told me that they completed it in few hours. And that is what the aim is, you know, just to be a kind of a checkpoint whenever you feel low or you feel that you can't do anything. So that's the pure aim, to inspire more and more people to aspire for more.
Very nice. Actually, it's a very good thought process that you have. And as what you said, it is through your journey of life, you know, where you thought like, okay, you have interacted with women and they need to be boosted at times because, you know, they are very strong. I mean, I need not tell you that because you are from the same species. And Nemlekar ma'am also belongs, you know, to that criteria where, I mean, she fits into that because she also started her tutorials, from zero. And then it, by, you know, rest is history because all you guys made it a success. And that's how it is, all the powers to be, all the positive energy come together and, see to it that things work out. So I'm very happy that you thought about this book. I want to also confide in you something and my viewers that, I read this book in just one sitting. I opened the book and it went on, it was so interesting that within maybe an hour or two, I finished off the 96 pages. I reverted back to you, thanking you about it. Now, I want to also ask you that does education play a very important role in this aspect about women sometimes getting a little subdued or they don't actually react the way they should, when they know they have the potential in life? What is your opinion on this?
I think it does. Education is the founding base where people can build up on their career. If you have education, you're recognized, you get into those roles which you want. Also, more important with education is self-awareness. Being self-aware about your own strengths, weaknesses. What happens usually, is that we all women think about the external barriers we have. Someone told us something and someone is in a hurdle. Someone is not supporting in family to grow big. Someone doesn't want us to travel after 7 p.m. All this actually is in our mind. More important is to overcome your internal barriers. And that's where self-awareness helps. So education obviously is a foundation base. But also all of, women and men both have to be more self-aware. What they really are and what they want to do. I think both of these play a very key role. Okay. Internal barriers, breaking internal barriers is, in our mind, it is very important. Then you can go and achieve anything.
I also want to ask you the next question. Actually, it's a question which is preceding to this only. Did you meet across certain people or certain women while you were traveling and then you felt that, they do require to be given a boost? And that's how this germ came into your mind. I write this book. I wouldn't know how you named it as Boss Lady. That also is a question I'll ask you later on. So is that a fact that, you must have met a lot of women and then you thought that I should pen this book?
Yeah. So I did, I interact with a lot of women when I travel across the country and across the globe. And lot of them in Asia also. One thing, I always had this preconceived notion that rural women would need, because they don't have education, they don't grow up and, go up the ladder. And urban women, maybe, they make a choice. But sometimes it is different, right? I see a lot of urban women don't have that confidence, or maybe because they are nuclear families, they have a lot of child care and primary caregiving things to do. Yeah. Whereas rural women are more, even if they're not educated, they have a lot of confidence, I saw. And that is one thing I want to tell the audience, that we have a lot of preconceived notions. But that self-awareness, I have seen so many entrepreneurs who don't have that level of education, but they are very self-aware and very confident and they'll say, I'll, achieve that. So a lot of, and everywhere I saw, there is a lack of self-love when it comes to women. And even for men also, we'll talk about conditioning later, but self-love is something which is very important. It is not selfish. We women think that it is very selfish to think about ourselves before family. But sometimes, and you don't have to do elaborate things, you just need to grab a cup of coffee which you made for yourself. That is also self-love. So I think more and more women need to practice that often.
I agree with you. You know why? Because this is a very simple example. When you board a flight, the air hostess tells that, place the oxygen mask on your face first and then go for your neighbor to be helped.
Exactly.
During a disaster. God forbid, there should not be a disaster. But I think women in, we are generally in our continent or maybe in our country, they are, they always feel family first. I should take care of my family. Her health becomes secondary or her priorities become secondary. They don't even, sorry to interrupt you, they don't even take care of how they can groom themselves, though they are presentable and they always feel so old. I mean, I don't require because, you know, my husband is there, my child is there. But I think that also plays a major role, according to you, Smita.
It does, it does. And even, you know, the sabzis in our dining table are what the men like, right? And it is a conditioning we all have. And it's no wrong. You know, you should put your family first, but both men and women should be partners. And I have a fabulous partner. I've spoken about him in the book also. And it is a 50-50 partnership for us, you know. And both our strengths and weaknesses complement. So I have been through that. So I really think that can give, you know, he is the wind beneath my wings. So, you know, it's really good. So I think that is what, and sometimes, you know, I realize that we don't ask for help as women. It is our problem. We think we are superwomen and we have to make everything perfect, you know, that 3-course meal every day. So sometimes we should ask for it. And I have got help from all sectors when I've asked for it, you know, be it family, be it friends, be it colleagues. Sometimes I myself had an hesitation if how will I ask? Will they think I'm incompetent? So all of this, I feel, is in our minds. Let's ask for it. You know, what will you hear? A no? Then you are by yourself. But if you hear a yes, it's very good. So don't hesitate for us to help. You know, there is no concept like superwoman and
very
a perfect
nice.
Woman.
Very nice. Very nice. It's for, even for men, you know, men like us, you know, they say men are chauvinistic sometimes, you know, and they don't want to. I mean, not all, please, you know, forgive me, my dear friends, all my fraternity. It's not that I'm blaming everyone in this thing. There are specific people. I mean, there are certain people who may have ego issues. Ki nahi, what I do is right. So I think there should be compatibility between a man and a woman, you know, post-marriage or during their friendship or whatever. There should not be an ego issue. Isn't it? Do you agree with me on this?
Yeah, it's a teamwork. It's a teamwork, right?
Yeah.
And I think for men also, no, not to blame them, they also have been conditioned in certain way, you know, kind of not to try, you know, always being the highest earning member in the family, not to maybe not help in the, because they've seen that happening. So both men and women have their own conditioning. I think they both need equal help to break through that.
Yeah, I mean, this philosophy is very beautiful when you say that we are interdependent. I mean, you know, like we are not independent. Like, you know, you can't just say neither men nor a woman,
nor a woman.
We are all, that's the reason nature has made us that way. Isn't it? We are self-dependent. Yep. And if we realize that, I think most of the issues will be taken care of, isn't it?
Yep.
The next question I would like to ask you is, do you think women play a major role in future times to come on the global scenario? What is your point of view?
See, in pandemic, I think all of us have been talking about, you know, more women at the top, because it is no more an authoritative leadership. It's more about empathy and, you know, knowing what your employees want. And I think there will be more women at the top, definitely. What we need to do is bridge that gap. We see a lot of women at the entry-level jobs.
Okay.
Yeah, but somewhere on the ladder, they drop out. I think if we manage to get that right, there'll be more women on top. And it should be a mix of both men and women. But we don't need to make a law for that, I think. You know, it should be genuinely that people go by their credibility and by their achievements, right? It should not be that 33% women in the board should be, you know, people in the board should be women.
It's a conscience which should, you know, make a person feel key, you know, this is how it should be. There should not be legalities everywhere or maybe force. It has to be mutual consent or maybe conscience which says, okay, I think I'll allow this particular woman who is actually capable of taking the helm of the company. And I think, Smita, this awareness will be slowly created once people like you write books, interact with people. Like, I'll tell you what, I want to, confide in you one more thing. Like, you know, we have been, Daisar Connect and or Nemlikar Kala Academy always used to have interactive sessions, you know, at places like Prabodhankar Thakre. We used to invite audience and there used to be interactive sessions. We had also gone to different places and interacted with students at different colleges. So this is how it should be. I would rather go one step further, saying that, you know, like I would collaborate with you when things are normal, when we could have sessions in different theater.
Wonderful.
Call,
yeah.
And then we can call men and women together. It's not only a woman dominated scenario, because in fact, if men would change their attitude, there would be a tremendous difference in the society. That's what I feel. So more of men should attend this kind of programs. And then they should convey their thought process to a woman saying that, okay, my dear friend, I have changed. Isn't it?
Yep.
This is what I feel. I want to also ask you one more thing, Smita. I mean, I missed out during my introduction. Could you elaborate on that portion where your book has been referred with the first, vice president in the United States of America? Can you just elaborate on that?
Yeah, so it's a presidential magazine which featured Kamala Harris, and it was an Australian-American publication with associated with the White House. And this was a preview article I've written before the book, which is called Self-Love is Not Selfish. And it had a few Indians who also wrote, two or three of us who had, a lot of articles were given, and mine was selected to publish there. So it was actually in March I had submitted, and then I had no hope that it would do. But suddenly one morning I wake up and it was published, and it was an awesome moment, because Kamala Harris is a good idol for all of us, right?
Yeah.
And it's a good moment, and people reading it across the globe, something you have written, which is good, for a debut author like me, it's very good.
True. And actually, for a small place like Dahisar, why I always emphasize on that, because Dahisar Connect is mainly to give that importance to a place where we used to always feel like Dahisar mein kya hai. People used to feel Churchgate mein jada hai hai, go to Bandra. Yeah. No, I think Dahisar also has people like Smita Shetty, whose parents also have played a major role. Your sister Shweta has played a major role, in grooming you and also in this book. So I think I want people to know that, Dahisar has got such a kind of a talent, and the word should spread. I feel like, you can also advise as to how you would plan to reach this book out to the book to the Dahisar Connect viewers. Do you have any strategy, or do you think they can connect with you to buy the book from any place?
Yes, they can. My credentials can be shared with them, and they can connect to me. And if I definitely it's not about, the sole motto is to reach more people. It's an extension of mine. So I really wanted to reach more and more people, read it, review it, recommend it. So I would definitely plan out something for, if they come through reference on Dahisar Connect, we'll definitely plan out something for them.
Very nice. See, there were a few women who I have interviewed on this platform. Miss Vedika Mehta, she is a founder of Vedika International, and she exports her products to 23 different countries. Okay. And she's from, of course, Borivali. But she's got all her friends and family members and relatives in Dahisar and Borivali. So we are all close-knit. It's not like Dahisar and Borivali are different.
Yeah.
So, she also would be very happy to connect with you. And post the interview, I would definitely request her to coordinate with you. I got a person by the name of Unnati Shah, who's also a person who trains people. And, she's a nutritionist. So, there are good number of people who are on the success ladder, and they would like to associate with you probably. I've got Siddhi Palande, who's a blogger and one of the most, sought after blogger in our country. And you'll not believe, she is also a Nemlikarite. So I want you to coordinate with her, and I'm sure she would advise you how the book goes further down to thousands of people. So I would request all of you to coordinate with Smita and take it forward.
And that's the power of platform, right? That's the power of platform you have built.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And I want to ask you a last question. If I missed out on anything, you can still further elaborate. You have something like Sakhi, which is your organization.
Yeah, Sakhi Tribe.
Yeah, so through which you interact with women all over the globe. So would you like to say something about it? So, you know, the women folk can interact.
Sakhi tribe was something which I started, I think, 7-8 months ago. It's an Insta platform. It's on an Insta platform. But it has around, I think, more than 200 women who interact with each other. And it's just building a tribe of women supporting women. So like you said, Unniti, Vedika, all of these, you know, these are women supporting women, right?
Siddhi.
Yeah. So this is what the tribe is. You know, it's just a platform to be open, what you want to share. I also mentor on that platform young women or girls who want to build up their career or anything and everything you can mentor on, right? So they connect to me and we talk one-to-one. So a lot of this happens on Sakhi Tribe. It's an open forum for everyone. And it's like a free of cost platform for all of us to talk and learn from each other. And if we can learn from each other's failure, we fail fast, we succeed faster. So whatever I have achieved in 15 years, if someone can learn from me and then do it that in 5, I think I'll be more proud of them. So that's what Sakhi Tribe is.
Very nice, very nice. So is that on Instagram or?
Yeah. I can share that page also. Yeah, it's on Insta. Yeah.
So there are some more people, and if I missed out on somebody, I am extremely sorry. I've got Dr. Ami Sanghvi, who was interviewed on this platform. She's one of the leading diabetologists from Mumbai, and she's a Daisarite. So
we know her. You know, my parents' doctor she is, and she got my book recently. I think 2 weeks back. So I've gifted her one book. I hope she's reading it.
The world is small, you know, that's how it is. How Daisar Connect gets all of them. But there's a person by the name of Shailja Shelly. She's a person who's on radio, you know, like she's got a platform where she interacts with the stories on radio. So why I'm giving you all these references, I want you to interact with them and take this forward. So before we wind up, do you have a few words of advice or maybe, you know, like what women should do to enhance their personality?
I think three things, you know, what what I have used. Do not let anyone tell you that you can't. That is the first step. Because once you allow people to tell you that, you start believing in it. So that's a cycle. Second, never give up on your dreams. Come whatever may, you know, ask for support, ask for help, find a shoulder to climb up, but ask for it. It's very important, you know, before giving that dream up, just ask for that last help. And third, as I said, self-love is not selfish. So love yourself a bit more, you know, do small things, go on a drive, go on a place you like, do something for yourself that is self-love. You know, you don't have to buy extravagant things or go on a big holiday. Just small things daily, spending the first 15 minutes of the day with yourself, that is self-love and it is not selfish. Three things I want to tell both men and women.
Very nice. Before I wind up, again, some thought process which has come into my mind. Does a family play a very important role in, you know, making a success of a woman? What is your experience?
See, I always don't believe when people say I'm self-made, because no one is self-made. There is someone behind that person who has toiled their life. My parents, you know, my father believing in me and not, putting me in a silo because I'm a girl, you know, that is very important, because in that generation it happened, right? But
thank you so much that you were there on the Daisar Connect today on DC Celeb Talk. And with more and more books which you'll be writing further down, or anything new coming up, you know, we'll definitely connect. And when things are normal, I'm sure, as I mentioned during the course of the interview, we'll have a live session where we will, meet people across and interact with them across the stage, you know, in the auditorium. My regards to your parents.
Looking forward to that.
My regards to your parents who have brought up a very nice and a cultured child, you and Shweta, both of you. And also to your husband, who has been so cooperative and loving towards you to make you what you are today. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
God bless you. God bless you.
Thank you so much, sir. Bye-bye.
Yeah.